I would like to thank Dr. Tillu and the Vice Chancellor of Savitribai Phule University, Pune, Dr. Karmalkar sir, for giving me this opportunity to come over here and share my ideas about weight loss and prevention of diabetes. Or now we are saying management of diabetes. We are not only into prevention, but we want to now manage also. The topic is effortless, and the reason of using this word effortless is to lure the obese people. Because all obese people want that somebody else should lose their weight. They don't want to do anything. So we have put this word effortless. But what I am going to tell you is not exactly effortless, but it is less effort. Because what you do to lose weight, if you compare what I am saying, you will find what I am telling you is very easy, sustainable, you can follow. Because people do so many bizarre things to lose weight. Before 8 days, my friend's wife called me. And she said, you must tell your friend, otherwise I will be taking divorce. I said, 25 years after marriage, what must have happened? Must be some pati patni wo, some sort of issue. Then I asked her, what happened? She said, no, that way he is very good. But thing is, he is dieting nowadays. I said, why you should be unhappy? Any wife should be happy. Husband losing belly is a good news. She said, no, but he is eating only cabbage in the breakfast, lunch and dinner. I said, then what is the problem? You save your wheat and rice. She said, no, that's not the problem. The problem is now he smells like a cabbage. 25 years back, I have not married a cabbage. I married this person. So people can go to any extent and they can do anything to lose weight. But compared to that, what I will be telling will be very easy, which you can follow. I have given the email address. The purpose is, if you have any query afterwards, feel free to write. You will get an answer within 8 days. That's our commitment from the campaign. All the credit of this theory, this initiative, this campaign goes to late Dr. Jiskar. What I am going to tell you was told by Dr. Jiskar from 1997 to 2004. 7 long years he was doing this campaigning. Because of his unfortunate death in 2004, at a very young age, this campaign was at a standstill at that time. And when I heard his lecture on YouTube in 2012, I got charged, inspired, I practiced it. Then research on that, and then with new data we are coming to you and we are propagating this campaign. So this campaign is and lecture is dedicated to memory of late Dr. Jiskar. I am talking to people from university, and that too Pune University. So I have to be very careful, because as a teacher for last 28 years in medical colleges, you know that we feel we teach a lot of things to the students. But what a student learns is very important. So I will be doing my job 100%. You have to do your job of understanding 100%. Then only the transaction will be successful. Let me tell you who am I not. I am not a practicing doctor. I am not a nutritionist or dietitian. Nowadays these people are very popular. Not only popular, but our MD medicine doctors want to learn from dietitians. And these nutritionists have become so arrogant nowadays that they are saying that doctors are quacks in the field of nutrition. So almost 9 years we studied in medical colleges. Somebody is calling us quacks, but I am not a dietitian, fortunately. I am not a diabetologist also. I am not a fitness expert. So many people must be thinking that Dr. Tillu has invited a wrong person. Because I am talking about weight loss and diabetes management, and I am not expert in any of this field, because we are used to listen to only experts and specialists. So my teacher used to say in Lakshmi Road, on Lakshmi Road, if you find a specialist of left nostril and another specialist of right nostril, you should not be surprised. And this is the era of specialization. But I am a sincere researcher, a very dedicated teacher. I was given the Best Teacher Award of Maharashtra University of Health Sciences 2015-16. Best Teacher Medical Faculty and Best of Best Teachers All Faculty. I am a teacher, dedicated teacher, honest researcher and health activist. I spent 28 years in medical colleges with two purposes of my life. One was to create social awareness in medical students, and second, to create health awareness in the society. So let it be clear that whatever I am going to tell you, I don't have any vested interest in this theory. We don't want to earn a single rupee from you today or even in the future also. It's absolutely free of cost. And last thing that I want to tell you is that I may not have answers for all your questions. Sometimes your questions, you will have to find answers for yourself. The lifestyle modification that I am going to suggest you has got four objective effects. These are the four objective parameters on which you can judge any diet plan or any lifestyle modification for that matter. And these parameters are reduction in your weight, reduction in your waist circumference. Third is reduction in HbA1c. Now what is HbA1c? It is called glycosylated hemoglobin, which gives you the average blood glucose of last 3 months, which is used for monitoring in patients of diabetes, whether the diabetes is controlled or not. And lastly, it is reduction in fasting insulin. You know, insulin is a hormone in your body, and the level of fasting insulin will decrease. These are the four parameters. And if this can happen with any diet plan or any lifestyle modification, no doctor on earth can say this is bad. All doctors have to say this is good. And if any diet plan other than what I am telling you can do this, we should be happy to accept that. I don't say this is a lecture. I say it is a life-changing experience. I can assure you that tomorrow will not be the same like today. And I tell diabetics that before coming for the lecture, take your selfie. And after the lecture is over, take another selfie. 10% glow will increase on your face. Because you will get hope. That's very important. So it is a life-changing experience. If you follow what I am saying, your life will change, that's for sure, which has changed for millions of people in this country. It will happen to you also. So let me start with some success stories. And these are the success stories of people who followed this diet plan and then achieved something which will maybe impress you that how it works. I'll start with ex-Vice Chancellor, Dr. Rajan Velukar, who has a rare privilege of being Vice Chancellor of two universities, YCMOU as well as Mumbai University. And Dr. Velukar is a chronic diabetic. He is having diabetes since 1998, almost 20 years now. And he was treated by eminent diabetologist in Mumbai. I don't take the name, but he is a Padma Shri award winner. February 2018, Dr. Velukar contacted me. At that time, his HbA1c was 10.3. Let me tell you that HbA1c up to 5.6 is normal. 5.7 to 6.4 is pre-diabetes. 6.5 onwards is diabetes. So, and if it is below 7, we say that with treatment, diabetes is under control. But Velukar's value at that time was 10.33, that you can see on the table. And then he asked me, will this help me? I said, it is science. It has to help everybody. And then he followed it. And what happened? Look at his figure in November, it has become 6.6. And look at the medicines he was taking. He was taking 5 medicines at 3 times, breakfast, lunch, dinner. Today, since last 3 months, he is not taking any medicine. He is off medicine. And still his HbA1c is 6.6. This can happen to Dr. Velukar. And Dr. Velukar is a professor of statistics himself. So sometimes he used to take blood sugars 5 times in a day, early morning. Because he wanted to do experiments on himself. And he used to send me those files. So this has happened to Dr. Velukar. And Dr. Velukar came all the way from Nagpur to Mumbai by flight on his own, not asking for any travel expense. And in Shanmuganand Mahali, explained this success story to the audience. Sumant Gaisas, treasurer of Siddhivinayak Trust, Mumbai. HbA1c was 10.1, diabetes uncontrolled. Now within 6 months, it has become 6.2, medicine stopped. Rupal Mani lost 7 kg weight, converted from pre-diabetic to non-diabetic. Jitendra Vaghela, who is from Nandurbar, he lost 12 kg in 4 months. HbA1c is on declining trend. Akash Kamble, you can see the change in his appearance. HbA1c 11.72. 11 kg weight loss. Vinayak Fadnis, 18 kg weight loss in 2.5 months. You can see the change. Arun Shidde, converted from diabetic to pre-diabetic, weight loss 12 kg in 3 months. Ajit Badke, primary teacher from Prathardi, 22 kg weight loss in 1 year. Amit Pardeshi, 17 kg in 6 months. Dr. Siddharth Kulkarni, medical officer from Alibag, 15 kg weight loss in 4 months, converted from diabetic to non-diabetic. You may think that there is some Photoshop trick because he is wearing the same t-shirt. But then he told me he has cut it just to show that it is the how it looks now. Dr. Dange is orthopedic surgeon from Udgir near Latur. And you can see two pictures. One picture is sitting on the sofa and cutting cake. That is his last birthday. And this year he followed diet plan for 4 months. He lost almost 20 kg. He was taking glimepiride 1 milligram twice a day. Still his HbA1c was 9. Today without medicine his HbA1c is 5.6. And now he can sit on the ground, fold his legs. And possibly his eating choice has also changed. So he's not cutting cake this time. So this can happen. And when I am giving you any example of any success story, then I have got all records of that. I am a professor. I got records of each and every value that I am telling you. I got mobile numbers of everybody. So you can talk to these people. And if you visit our Facebook page that is called Effortless Weight Loss, Dr. Dixit, Dr. Jiskar, you will find thousands of success stories with mobile numbers and all. So you can talk to these people and confirm for yourself what really happened. Dr. Walwekar, oncosurgeon from Nashik, converted from diabetes to non-diabetes, 6.9 to 5.3, lost 16.5 kg. Professor Shyam Lendwe from Latur, HbA1c was 10.1. This was 1st January 2017. And he was started 3 medicines by diabetologist as per the guidelines. We follow the guidelines. And then he followed the diet plan. He walked 6 kilometers every day instead of 4.5 kilometers that we advise. And ate only twice. And on 16th August 2017, he became non-diabetic. And 16th August 2018, we celebrated his first birthday of diabetes-free life. And today also, he is not taking any medicine. He is off medicines. In Ramchandra, customs officer from Karwar, HbA1c was 11.5. Actually, collapsed in the office. His blood sugar was 485 at that time. He followed the diet plan. 6 months, it became 5.15. Today also he is without medicines. Nilesh Mahajan, bank employee from Nashik, HbA1c reduced from 11.8 to 5.6, became non-diabetic. Still he is non-diabetic. Rupa Sane, she is from Pune. Her HbA1c was 16.3, average blood sugar around 380. And when she had shown me the reports, I said, you are a sugar bomb. You should start medicines and then you can also start the diet plan. But she said, I don't want to take any medicine. I said, there is a risk involved. She said, I am ready to take any risk. I said, give in writing. So she gave me in writing. And she followed it. Now it is 7.3 without medicines. Why I am telling you all these success stories? Just to tell you that lifestyle modification can cause weight loss. It can revert your diabetes. It can revert your pre-diabetes. It's not very difficult. It is your own body that can help you. You don't have to take any external help for that. You must have tried to lose weight, many of you. But most of you fail in losing weight. There are various reasons. The first reason, you go for a diet plan that will starve you. They'll tell you to skip lunch or dinner or take some powder, some shake, something like that. So effectively you don't eat one meal. If you don't eat one meal, you lose some calories. So if you take less calories, naturally you will lose some weight. But then when you realize that life cannot be like this, drinking a shake, that cannot be your life. You want to eat mango juice and you want to eat pakodas. So when you realize that, you will stop it. You stop it, again your weight will come back to normal level. Costly diet plans, people cannot afford. Then diet plans which are difficult to follow. They will tell you to do things that which are very difficult to follow for a long time. Then diet plans that require very close monitoring. They will give you the timetable of what you should eat in 24 hours. So always there is a tension in your mind that whether I am doing it correctly or not. You have to follow that. You have to then collect those food items and eat at that. So you cannot follow it for longer time. And lastly, a certain diet plans which are culturally alien. This lady from Pune called me and she said, "Sir, I am fed up with the diet plan." I said, "What happened? Are you not losing weight?" She said, "No, I lost 2 kg. I said, "Then what is the problem? What are you doing?" She said, "I eat chicken for breakfast, mutton for lunch and fish for dinner." I said, "That's good. They are all nutritious food items. What is the problem?" She said, "But sir, I was a vegetarian." So if you advise like that, naturally diet plan is going to fail. I have given you many reasons why diet plans fail, but there is a fundamental reason, and the reason is that obese people want that somebody else should lose their weight. They don't want to take responsibility of their weight. Unless and until you take responsibility of your weight, it will never reduce. So the first step to lose weight is taking responsibility of your own weight. Nobody is going to help you. You have to help yourself. So in 2012, I had put on 8 kg weight. So I was not obese. Nobody called me obese. But then I tried different methods to lose weight. Fasting, then eating fruits, General Motors diet. How many have tried? GM diet? I cannot believe this. This is Pune University. Heard about, not tried. Okay. So all those diets I tried. I tried everything possible. And then I couldn't lose weight. So I came to this conclusion that probably this may be the only way of burning your fats. Now you laughed at this cartoon. What is this? This is called as liposuction or bariatric surgery. So we take out your fats. 1 liter will cost 30,000, 40,000 like that. People die also in these operations. And then sometimes we cut your stomach so that your capacity of you are eating 15 chapatis. We reduce your capacity by cutting that stomach and you can eat only now 3 chapatis. So these are the cruel methods of losing weight. Will you like to do this? Nobody would like to do this. So this picture and this picture, there is qualitatively no difference. Qualitatively they are on the same lines. But then I was in lookout for a diet plan which will be successful. And to be successful, it must have following criteria. First, it should be free of cost. Second, should not require a doctor or expert. Third, you should not be asked to purchase a machine or any nutritional supplement. And most important part is you should be able to follow it for a lifetime happily. And if any diet plan will fulfill all these conditions, then you should accept that diet plan. And I was lucky to get such a diet plan. One of my friends forwarded me the YouTube lecture of Dr. Jiskar. That lecture is available today also. If you go to YouTube and put the words Pune Fitness Movement or Nagpur Fitness Movement, you will get this lecture. But just a word of caution. Now when you listen to the lecture of Dr. Jiskar today, you have to listen to get inspired. For technical details, follow what I am saying. Because he is our mentor. But technology in 1997 was rudimentary. To test insulin and all was very difficult. So we have verified each and everything that Dr. Jiskar said in his lecture. And whatever stood to the test of time, we are telling you. So to get inspired, listen to his lecture. To know the technical details, listen to what I am saying. To reduce your weight, follow what I am saying. And in that lecture, he gave a very simple advice. That advice, he said, if you want to lose weight, if you want to remain healthy, you must eat only twice in the day. In between, if you will open mouth, it should be for speaking or drinking water. That was a simple advice. I was really surprised. I heard the lecture 4, 5, 6 times. Whether he is saying that eat less, he is not saying that. Whether he is saying don't eat sweets, he is not saying that. Don't eat non-veg, he is not saying that. Don't eat oil or ghee, he is not saying that also. I was surprised that how it can happen. Because in medical college we learned calories in, calories out. More calories you consume, less you spend, you will put on weight. But you must have experienced that there are two friends. One friend is thin, other is bulky. And the thin friend will eat more chapatis than the bulky friend. But still he will not put on weight. So possibly the calories in, calories out formula works in poultries, it works in cattle, but doesn't work in human beings. And then I said, because Dr. Jiskar I knew very well, a very talented person, knowledgeable person with good intentions definitely. So I said, in any case I don't have any other option now, so let me try this. So I tried it for 3 months, sincerely. And the result was, within 3 months I lost 8 kg and 2 inches from my belly. Whatever I wanted happened in 3 months. And then, because the professor, if he understands and realizes that the diet plan was, then I started propagating it. I started telling to each and everyone. My condition was such that if I meet somebody, some stranger also on the road who is having a belly, I used to run behind him, catch him and tell him that I got something for you. And this will happen to you also. If you do this, what I am saying, 3 months, you will start catching people with belly. Now let's come to the theory. What is this theory all about? The theory is very simple. The theory is telling you, if the level of insulin, which is a hormone, increases in your body, in your blood, you become obese, you develop insulin resistance, and then you develop type 2 diabetes. Now this campaign, this modification, lifestyle modification, is only for type 2 diabetes. It's not for type 1. Let it be very clear to all of you. Because type 1 diabetes is that diabetes which is called juvenile diabetes, which occurs in children. It gets diagnosed at the age of 10 to 12 years. And in the children, insulin is not produced in the pancreas. So lifetime they have to take injections of insulin. So this diet plan is not for type 1, this is for type 2. How many of you are having diabetes? Can you raise your hands? Okay. Around 8 to 10% people are having diabetes in India. And here is also the same picture. So most of these people got diabetes at the age of 30 years, 40 years, 50 years. That is type 2 diabetes. So if your insulin level increases, you become obese, you develop insulin resistance and you get type 2 diabetes. This is the principle. Now insulin is secreted in a gland called pancreas, which is on the left side in your abdomen below the stomach. And the beta cells there produce insulin. Now insulin is produced in two ways in your body. One is called baseline secretion, which is around 18 to 32 units in 24 hours. The peculiarity is you cannot stop it. It is necessary for your survival. There is other way by which you secrete insulin is every time you eat, insulin would be secreted. And it is expected that the insulin, out of your total insulin requirement, 50% should come from baseline. And 50% you should secrete by eating episodes. Now, the insulin that you secrete because of eating has a peculiarity that every one of you has got, you will secrete a particular amount of insulin. If I give one chapati to 10 people, one may secrete 2 units, other may secrete 4, other may secrete 8 units. So it depends on the person and it is specific for that person. So he will secrete that amount. Every time he eats, that amount of insulin would be secreted. And one more peculiarity is, if you eat one chapati, suppose you are secreting 4 units of insulin, for one chapati you will secrete 4 units, for 2 chapatis also you will secrete 4 units. You will not secrete 8 units of insulin. And last thing, once you secrete insulin, you will take 55 minutes to secrete it again. It won't happen in 55 minutes again. What does that mean in reality? That when you are eating, if you finish your meals in 55 minutes, you will secrete insulin only once. But if you go beyond that, you will secrete insulin for every 55 minutes, you will secrete once. Is it clear what I said? Insulin secreted in two ways. Baseline 18 to 32 units, you cannot stop. Eating episodes, every time you eat, peculiar amount of insulin would be secreted. Less amount, more amount, same insulin. And once you secrete, 55 minutes, it won't be secreted again. That this is the theory. Now, what is the purpose of this insulin? Why it is secreted? It is secreted after you eat because it has to do with the end products of digestion. And you may eat hundreds of food items, but the end products are only three. Carbohydrates converting into glucose, proteins getting converted to amino acids, and fats getting converted to fatty acids. So if you eat 10 food items, 20, 30, you won't get 30 end products. You get only these three end products. Now your body is made up of millions of cells, and each cell will require energy for its function. And there are two sources. One is glucose. If you burn 1 gram of glucose, you will get 4 calories. And if you burn 1 gram of fatty acid, you will get 9 calories. So if you are a cell, what you like to burn? Like to burn glucose or fatty acid? What you like to burn? Fatty acid, because you get two times at least more calories. Similarly, all cells in the body are happy burning fatty acids, except the brain cells. They like glucose. They don't like fatty acids. So you will think that because in the blood there is glucose, there is fatty acid, and the blood is going to all the cells. So what should happen? The glucose should enter the cells and cells should use it. But it's not that easy, because on each cell there is a lock. We call it in technical language as insulin receptor. So the cells are having insulin receptors. So the insulin has to open the lock of insulin receptor, then only the glucose can enter in the cell. These locks are everywhere. These locks are there on the brain cells also, but brain cells have another mechanism of getting glucose from the blood. So they don't depend on insulin for that, because brain is an important organ. So the first function of insulin is to make glucose enter the cell. So the glucose enter the cell, cells would use it. Now suppose if there is more glucose in your blood, it is converted to a substance called glycogen in your liver. 100 grams in liver and 400 grams in your muscles. Now what is glycogen? It is nothing but the molecules of glucose would come together and form glycogen. What is the purpose of glycogen is? In case of emergency, if you don't eat anything for 10 hours, 12 hours, 15 hours, because your brain is working, kidneys are working, liver is working, they require energy. In that time, this glycogen would be broken down, you will get 400 calories of energy. So this is for emergency, you will have this store. Now the first function of insulin, taking glucose to cell. Second function, converting glucose to glycogen. Third function, very important, and this will enlighten some of you. If still there is more glucose in your blood, after these two functions are over, this is converted to fatty acids under the influence of insulin. Now this answers question of many people that I don't eat oil, I don't eat ghee, even I throw the yellow from the egg, still how, why I am obese? The reason is the chapati that you consumed, the rice you consumed, the dal you consumed, glucose from that was converted to fatty acid by insulin. So the hero and villain of the story is insulin. And insulin does all these tricks. It converts amino acids into proteins which are used by the body. It converts fatty acids into fats and stores. So insulin is called as anabolic hormone. It is called as a conserving hormone. And suppose the insulin levels go up, it is called as hyperinsulinemia. And if you search on Google, you will find thousands of research articles. And none of the articles would say it is good for health. They will say it is bad for health. What happens? Blood pressure will increase. You will become obese. Cholesterol will increase. And the worst thing that it causes is called as insulin resistance. Because your cells are not used to high levels of insulin. What is their expectation? When you eat, insulin should be secreted, and when the work is over, it should go down. It should reduce to zero level. That's the expectation. But if you keep it high, the cells develop resistance. And what do? They change their structure. So if they change the structure, what happens? The insulin cannot operate on the insulin receptor. The key cannot work. So now what happens? Suppose you are secreting 4 units of insulin every time you eat. But because of resistance, now what happens? The glucose cannot enter the cells. Brain gets a message. There is starvation. So the brain now says, because 4 units is not enough, let's increase it to 8 units. So now you start secreting 8 units of insulin every time instead of 4 units. This works for 4, 5, 6 months. Again resistance will increase. Then again brain will increase your secretion of insulin to 12 units. So ultimately a stage comes when your insulin is very high in the blood, the glucose is very high, but glucose cannot enter the cell because resistance is very high. And the glucose is passed through the kidneys and it is passed in the urine. Now your body will start getting calories from your muscles, that is proteins, as an exceptional condition. And you will start losing weight. You go to the doctor and fasting 250, post meal 350. Then we label you as type 2 diabetic patient. So what you realize, understood now is, it's not that you are not producing insulin, you landed into diabetes. But you produce too much of insulin, which is ineffective. That is the pathogenesis of type 2 diabetes. Now suppose your insulin level goes down, what will happen? First, glucose in the blood would be used. Then glycogen would be broken down and it will be used. And if then you don't eat anything, what will happen? If the money from pocket is over, money from cupboard is over, then you have to go to the bank and break your fixed deposit. So once your glucose is gone, glycogen is gone, then only your body will use fats. And then what happens? Wherever there is fat, it will be burned. So what does it mean? What is the lesson to be learned? If anyone on this earth wants to lose weight, lose belly, wants to burn fats, the only way available is to reduce your insulin level. There is no other way. And if you want to reduce your insulin level from tomorrow, whether you should eat less or you should eat less times. What's your take on that? Eat less or eat less times? Perfect. Because if you eat less also, same amount of insulin would be secreted. So you have to eat less times. Now find out how many times you are secreting insulin in your body. Morning you take tea with a spoonful of sugar. If you are secreting 4 units of insulin, 4 units secreted. You prepare tiffin for your child. You prepare some shira, eat 2 spoons just to test, 4 units secreted. Somebody comes, gives you Siddhi Vinayak Peda, Dagdu Halwai Peda. You eat, 4 units secreted. I had told you that tomorrow will not be the same like today. You will not be able to eat anything tomorrow. Every time the insulin bell will ring, you will remember me. Every time when you are eating something. But you will become aware of eating. If somebody gives you a peda, you will hold the peda in your hand. Look at the peda and think, is it worth secreting 4 units of insulin? So what I will do? I will keep it in bowl, eat during my lunch or dinner. That awareness will come. Because I ask people, why do you eat? Depending on the knowledge they tell about calories, proteins, then some people talk about molybdenum also. This is Department of Chemistry. But the real reason why you eat is, you eat because you get to eat. There is no other reason. Now suppose Dr. Tillu will circulate samosas here in the audience. How many people would not eat? Definitely, those who are following this diet plan will not eat, at least in front of me. And if it is free of cost, you will eat 2 samosas. Were you hungry for a samosa? Would you ask Dr. Tillu? Half hour is over, give us the samosa. No, you are not hungry for a samosa. You eat because you get to eat. That is the only reason. So look at the number of times you secrete insulin in the body and cut down all those unnecessary secretions. Now the simple method to lose weight, eat twice when you are really hungry. Generally human beings are hungry twice. Find out your real hunger times. Most of the people don't know when they are really hungry. because they eat before they are hungry. So there are two patterns in the world, 9 a.m., 6 p.m., 12:31, 8:39. So either of the pattern you can start. Within 8 to 10 days, trial and error, you will come to know what is your real time. So once you decide those times, eat at that time. 15-20 minutes variation is okay, but not too much of variation. Finish your meal in 55 minutes. Remember, I am not saying to eat 55 minutes. People hear what they want to hear. Why 55 minutes? Because insulin should be secreted only once. That's our idea. So you have got that much time. And it will happen to you. When you start this diet plan for first 8 days, you will collect all the food items that you want to eat and decorate your plate nicely and eat for 55 minutes, allowed, no problem. But that is the maximum time. You can finish within 10-15 minutes also. In between two meals, don't eat anything. Itna sannata kyun hai bhai? People say, sir, this is the most cruel sentence in your lecture. How will survive? You are eating so many times. But it's a matter of 8 to 10 days. You will get used to it. Then whatever people will offer you, you will not like to eat anything. But you will enjoy each and every bite of your meal. That's very important. Reduce sugars and sweets. Diabetics don't eat. Others also reduce as much as possible. Sugar, jaggery, honey are all siblings. Equally bad. So reduce as much as possible. And increase proteins in your meals. Non-vegetarian, no problem. Whatever they eat, chicken, fish, mutton, they will get good proteins. Vegetarians, rice 9%, wheat 11%, dal 20%. And how do you eat dal? In that bowl, below will be small layer of dal and complete curry. So what proteins you are going to get? So what you should do, vegetarians, if you are eating 4 chapatis, reduce 1, take a bowl of sprouts or thick dal, soybean, cheese, paneer, drink milk, so that your proteins would increase. Carbohydrates to be reduced. I am not telling you to stop anything. Or you will say, I'll stop eating chapatis now. Don't do that. Do things that you can follow for lifetime. This is not a diet plan. This is a lifestyle. So it is easy. If you can reduce 1 chapati out of 3, it's easy. You should not stop it. So this is a simple diet plan. Eat twice when hungry. Finish in 55 minutes. Don't eat anything in between two meals. Reduce sweets. Increase proteins. Many people are happy. But don't be very happy. First read what is written in the red line. Our aim should be two meals and water in between. Many people go on asking me, so whether this is allowed, that is allowed. I said, you should go to the water. Two meals and water. That should be your aim. Don't try to find out items that you can eat. There is no end to that. There are millions of items that you can eat. What is allowed? Water. Thin homemade buttermilk. Take 2 spoons of curd. Make 200 ml of buttermilk. You can take green tea, black tea if you like it. I am not recommending. Otherwise tomorrow you will ask me which company, which tea. I don't have any franchise. If you like, take it. You can take tea with 25% milk, 75% water. No sugar, no sugar substitute. You can take coconut water. Don't eat the pulp. Otherwise, 40 rupees ka nariyal laya, waste kaise karne ka? Malay. How to waste? Let me tell you, 50% of females in this state have become obese because of these 3 words. How to waste. And 90% of ladies who have got small kids, 1 or 2 years, they have become obese because of this. They will prepare something for the child and run behind the child 24 hours, forcing him to eat. The child will eat 3, 4, 5 spoons maximum, how much? And if they make shira, they will put lot of pure ghee, love and affection. And the child will eat 5 spoons. So, baki bacha, how to waste? Remember, you are taking care of dustbin of your house, but you are converting yourself into a dustbin. It's very easy to put food in your body. It's very difficult to take it out. Ask someone who is 110 kg. तो बोलता सर हवा भी खाऊं तो वजन बढ़ता है, वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू रिड्यूस वेट. आई एम नॉट सेइंग टू वेस्ट, आई एम सेइंग ईट ड्यूरिंग योर मील टाइम. यू कैन टेक द पल्प इन द बाउल, ईट, एंड यू कैन ईट मैक्सिमम वन टोमेटो. वन टोमेटो इज अलाउड. नाउ व्हाई दिस फूड आइटम्स आर अलाउड, बिकॉज दे वोंट कॉज इंसुलिन सिक्रीशन. वी हैव डन टेस्टिंग ऑन रीजनेबल नंबर ऑफ पीपल. आई डोंट से इट इज 100% फुल प्रूफ. वाटर इज 100% फुल प्रूफ. अदर आइटम्स, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू टेक एलोवेरा जूस, सर पीपल टेक सो मेनी थिंग्स इन द मॉर्निंग. एंड मेनी पीपल गो टू द जॉगिंग ट्रैक ओनली टू ड्रिंक जूस. There are so many stalls there on the ground. So if you want to take something specific to you, then you can test yourself for insulin secretion. If it doesn't cause secretion, you can take it. If it causes, stop it. What are the difficulties that you will encounter when you start a diet plan? First, how to get rid of tea with sugar. How many have this problem? Many must be having. I also had the same problem. But let me tell you. Now you can do a vrat of god or goddesses. You say 8 days I will drink tea without sugar. Okay. 9th day I will tell you will not like tea with sugar. I can assure you that. Because sugar is addictive. And the addiction takes around 8 days to wane. So it's very simple. It's a matter of 8 days. Will I get weakness or hypoglycemia? We are working, we are standing in the university 8 hours teaching and all that. Will I get hypoglycemia? Your body, if you are 65 kg, you have got 13 kg of fats in your body, which means 120,000 calories stock, and you require 2,000 calories per day. So if you don't eat anything for 60 days, drink only water, you are not going to die. That I can give you on bond paper as a doctor. So it's all psychological. Drink enough water. Experts insist on taking breakfast. We are not telling you to skip anything. We are telling you a natural thing. We are telling you, eat when you are hungry. Because if you eat when you are not hungry, you get indigestion. And if you don't eat when you are hungry, you get acidity. This is not a rocket science. This is your day-to-day experience. So we are not telling you to skip anything. If you are hungry at 8 in the morning, eat. You call breakfast. We say first meal. For us, there are only two words. First meal, second meal. Nothing like breakfast, lunch, dinner. So we are not telling you to skip anything. We are telling you to eat when you are hungry. It can be 8:30, it can be 9, it can be any time. The times are different for different people. But you fix those times, which are times of hunger for you. But then it causes problem. Then some professor from Pune called me, sir, I am getting acidity because of your diet plan. I said, what happened? I said, I am following for 8 days. I said, when you are, at what time you are hungry? She says, 8 in the morning. I said, when do you eat? She said, at 1 p.m. I said, naturally, 5 hours you keep yourself hungry, you will get acidity. Why you eat at 1? She said, our lunch break is at 1. Why you don't eat at 8? You have to eat at 8. She said, how it is possible? Said, why? Why it is not possible? Said, our housemate doesn't come. I said, do you want me to come? Now, which of your problems I can solve? I have given you the principle that you have to eat twice, no restriction on food item. Eat. So, we are not telling to skip anything. Will I lose muscles? Muscles means proteins. If you lose 1 kilogram protein, you will die. So, no wise body will use proteins for calories. So, muscles are last to be used for calories. Once the fat, glucose are over. Will I get acidity? Those who are having acidity, what is the advice given by doctors? Small, frequent meals, right? Has anybody's acidity gone because of that? No. How it will go? Put on the fire, then pour water. Put on the fire, pour water. This is going on 24 hours. Acidity won't go like that. Because acid secretion is also like insulin secretion. To start with, a peculiar amount would be secreted. And if you eat less, if you eat only one biscuit, what will happen? Some acid remains in your stomach. That causes you acidity. But those people who eat enough food twice a day, what happens? Their body gets a time to fine-tune how much acid is required. And that acid is used. So acidity is gone. So this diet plan, 30% success stories in the campaign are of those people who say our acidity has gone. I have to take medicines, no problem. Hypothyroidism. Many ladies are having hypothyroidism. So You can take that medicine, empty stomach, early morning, no problem with the diet plan. Other medicines, hypertension, all that, either the medicine is once or twice in the day. So adjust in first meal or second meal. So no problem with medicines. When to take fruits and milk? So I'll tell you the sequence, how to eat the food items. Start your meal with fruit, dry fruit or sweet dish. Then take salads, then sprouts, then rice, dal, vegetable and chapati. And at the end you can take milk. Well, let me remind you, it is not necessary to eat all the items in every meal. Otherwise, everybody will put on weight. But if you are going to eat, this is the sequence. So I answered most of it. And then, no time for exercise. We are so busy. Then I asked the question, why do you do all this? He said, I want to lead a good life. So do you mean good life is an ICU? A 5-star ICU? You want to lead your life? No. You have to spend time for yourself. There is no shortcut to lose weight. No medicine can cause weight loss. I don't know. Have you seen that belt is sold on internet? Slim sweat, something like that. It is the height of wishful thinking of obese people. What you have to do? Buy that belt. Sit on the sofa comfortably. Apply that belt. Bring a cold drink bottle. 2-3 packets of wafers. If you want to mix something in the cold drink, get that also. Then start football match. And then sleep. And then put on the button. It will move. You will sweat. You will lose 500 grams. And you drink some water, you will again put on weight. Can anyone lose weight like that? But still people buy such belts. One more thing, you will start the diet plan from tomorrow and after 8 days you call me. Sir, I am doing for 8 days, nothing has happened. Nothing is going to happen. Look at your story, how you put on weight. The lady says, at the time of marriage, I was 48 kg. First delivery, 58. Second delivery, 68. Now everything is settled, I am 78. Husband says, I was 51 at the time of marriage. Looking after this family, now I become 81. So try to understand, you put on weight in 20 years, 25 years, 30 years. It took years, decades. How you can lose it in 1 month? No, you must give 1 or 2 years to lose. See, when you follow this diet plan, within 1 month you will come to know that your direction is correct. You will start feeling energetic, fresh. You will get good sleep. Some lucky people, their clothes also would become loose. But to see objectively weight loss, you have to do it for 3 months. So from your life, I want only 3 months, 90 days. If you don't get result, don't do it for 91st day. But if you get result, then spread it to your near and dear ones. Diabetics, pre-diabetes also can use. Nowadays we say that the main function of the diet plan is to reverse diabetes. Weight loss is a side effect. So diabetics and pre-diabetes also can follow, but they have to do two tests, HbA1c, fasting insulin. Communicate with us those reports. If we say follow, you can follow, you will be benefited. Now what is the importance of these two tests, HbA1c, fasting insulin? HbA1c, I said up to 5.6 is normal, 5.7 to 6.4 pre-diabetes, 6.5 onwards is diabetes. Because what happens is, if I tell you to do blood sugars tomorrow, what you will do? You will not eat much today and you will not eat any sweet, definitely, because you are afraid to get diagnosed of diabetes. But if I do HbA1c, then I come to know that if you eat some sweets 2 months back also, it will be shown. So HbA1c is a necessary test. And fasting insulin. Now fasting insulin, when you are fasting, it should be near zero. Though the lab may say 3 to 27 is a normal range. But when you are fasting, there is no role of insulin. It should be minimum. At least it should be below 10. More than 10, we call it as pre-diabetes. That is the reason you have to do these two tests. When I started this campaign in 2013-14, all over Maharashtra, the rates of this test were around 1200 to 1700. When I talked to people here in like Dhande, Metropolis, Godvilkar and all in Pune, I told them that this campaign is completely charitable, free of cost. We don't want a single rupee from you today or tomorrow. In 3 days, the rates fell to 600 rupees. So all over Maharashtra now, wherever you go, this is the success of the campaign, that the rates have gone down from 1200 to 600. And anybody who wants to join the campaign has to get these two tests done. and share the reports with us. Any support from religion and culture? Ayurveda says dvau kal bunjita, right? Like Agnihotra, which you light it in the morning and evening. So when your Agni is strong, you eat twice. In Vedas it is written, the one who will eat twice will get the punya of fasting. And we do everything for getting punya. This is the easiest way to get punya. Jainism, there is a concept called Vyasana. Vyasana is Be-asana. Be-asana is sit twice and eat at that time. And Jain Munis told me, their religion has given 48 minutes for meal. I said, I have given 7 minutes as grace period. Gautam Buddha has told of Gautam Buddha has told the followers that if you want to lead healthy life, skip your dinner, eat only one, because he was a yogi. Dr. Shelton has written his book that why the Greeks are considered to be the strongest and healthiest people in the world, because they ate only twice in the day. Our saints said the same thing. What they said? The one who will eat once is a yogi. The one who eats twice is a bhogi. And one who eats thrice is a knowledgeable people come for lectures. There is actually no need to give this lecture. Everybody knows it. The problem is you don't practice it. That's the problem. And when you start practicing this, you will see the change in your health and your life. I just look for images of gods and goddesses of different countries, different religions. What I found? That no god is having a belly. All are flat. And some gods like Shankar are six packs also. And Ganpati is an exception. Don't ask about Ganpati. An exception. And there is a demon shown on the right side, who is having a belly. So there are no social status associated with having belly in our country. But that was old things. Now let me tell you something new. Dr. Matson is a researcher on intermittent energy restriction. And he published this research paper about meal frequency and timing in health and disease. And what is the conclusion? He says, the most common eating pattern in modern societies, 3 meals plus snacks every day, is abnormal from an evolutionary perspective. So human beings are not supposed to eat so many times. That's what Dr. Madsen is saying. So everybody is saying the same thing. Saints are telling the same thing. The only thing is when you will understand and follow it, that's the only thing. With this diet plan, we are recommending a simple exercise, cardio, any cardio, 45 minutes at a stretch. It can be walking, running, cycling, swimming. But do it for 45 minutes at a stretch. Why? First 20 minutes, glucose will be burned. Then your fats would be touched. So do it for 45 minutes. Scientific evidence, there are many research papers published, which you can get on Google. This is the first one. We followed 428 people for 6 months. What was the result? In 6 months, they lost 6.8 kg weight. The range, 3 kg to 32 kg. That's why I say it is a life-changing experience. There was a girl whose weight was 78 kg. She followed diet plan for 6 months. She lost 25 kg. Her life changed. What happened? She got married next month. There's a diabetic. His medicine stopped. Life changed. What was his life? Always thinking about whether to take medicine before lunch, during lunch or after lunch. And what to do if I get hypoglycemia? That was his life. He became free from that. And this is the only diet plan where you lose your belly first. Your cheeks would never retract. Otherwise you do gymming, eat proteins. First your cheeks will retract. And people start asking questions. Any problem at home? But here nobody is going to ask that question to you. Okay. You lose 3.5 centimeters from your belly in 6 months. Range 1 to 10 centimeters. Diabetes prevention, another paper published. One Ayurvedic doctor, lady doctor, she had her fasting insulin 24.4. She followed diet plan for 1 year. It reduced to 5.4. What does that mean in reality? It means her body was requiring 24 units of insulin in fasting state to function. And now she can do with 5 units. It means her body has become sensitive to insulin. resistance has decreased and diabetes is postponed now. Pre-diabetes reversal also can happen. Another paper published with a diabetologist from Aurangabad. 48 patients were studied. All were having HbA1c 5.7 to 6.4. They were told no medicine, eat twice, walk 4.5 kilometers. What is the result? In 3 months, all of them became non-diabetic. Diabetes reversal, I give the example of Professor Shambhlindwe. Within 7.5 months, he became non-diabetic. Still he is non-diabetic. But suppose tomorrow you come to know that your HbA1c is raised. Don't start medicine. Give a trial to this diet plan for 1 month. If you find your HbA1c is improving, don't go to any doctor. You don't require doctor. You can revert your diabetes yourself. In this country, diabetes is underdiagnosed because we do it with sugars. If you do HbA1c, then 30% more pre-diabetes would get diagnosed. And if they follow this diet plan, they will become non-diabetic. And little time is given for lifestyle modifications. We bombard patients with medicines. Because diabetes, type 2 diabetes is a lifestyle disorder. And if the cause is lifestyle, solution must be in the lifestyle. It cannot be medicines. And I am not saying this. For the very renowned research, which is called Diabetes Prevention Program, 3,234 pre-diabetics were divided into two groups. One group was given metformin. Other group was given lifestyle modification, dieting, exercise. And what are the result? Those who took metformin, in them, the chance of getting diabetes reduced by 40%. But those who modified lifestyle, in them, the chance reduced by 58%. So 18% more advantage was with lifestyle modification group. So our doctor should give us more chance to and support to modify the lifestyle. Now, what happens to diabetic patients? Those who raise the hand. This is your story. We conducted a study in the campaign. I am following 15,000 diabetics in my campaign. Out of them, we took 1,000 people and asked them, what's your progress? So, what their progress? At a time of diagnosis, metformin 500. After 3 years, 1,000. After 5 years, pioglitazone. After 8 years, glimepiride. After 15 years, insulin. 20 years, kidney damage. 25 years, retina damage. Is that the progress of diabetes? Is that what diabetologists wanted to do with their patients? Now some of them are arguing with me. I said, you can argue with me, no problem. But I am giving you evidence. You have to look at the evidence. If you find it is useful to you, use it. You have to treat diabetes. I am not going to treat diabetes. So what was the problem? The problem of lifestyle modification was, they were telling you to go for exercise. That was fine. But they were telling you to eat small, frequent meals. That has spoiled the world. And you have experienced that by eating small, frequent meals, you are landing into complications of diabetes. Nobody's diabetes is cured, right? So we are telling you something else. We are telling that if you eat twice, you can revert your diabetes. Even your medicines would stop. Another paper, which is editorial I wrote in one of the medical journals about diabetes, its treatment and prevention, are we on the right path? And then I wrote books on this theory. And 25th November, I released the book, Diabetes Reversal, New Hope. And in this book, I have given 54 success stories of people who could revert their diabetes. All authentic stories. And what is the purpose of this book is, and I am appealing all the people, I say that buy one copy for yourself and 10 copies for your doctors. And distribute to your general practitioner, homeopathic, ayurvedic, any doctor you meet, give a copy. Because most of the doctors want to help their patients, obviously. Many people ask me whether these doctors purposefully do this to us so that we should take lifetime medicines. No, it's not that. Because we are taught in medical college like that diabetes is incurable, diabetes is progressive. So when I diagnose a patient with diabetes, what is in my mind? I cannot cure him. And what is in your mind as a diabetic patient? You also know you cannot be cured. So both are with this defeated mentality. How it will be cured? Now we are giving you some solution. So I am telling diabetologists and physicians that try it out. on two types of patients. One, your uncontrolled diabetics. Those who have taken all medicines, still not controlled. So try 1 month. And those who are newly diagnosed diabetics, whatever is their HbA1c, don't worry. Give them this diet plan. So one book is this Diabetes Reversal New Hope. Other book is Vinasaya's Weight Loss, Effortless Weight Loss. That we released in Nagpur on the birthday of Dr. Jiskar in 2013. That was the first edition. Today, 20th edition of this book is in market. This year, we published 10 editions of this book. It has become so popular. These books I have got for you. If you want to buy, you can buy these books. They will cost you 150 rupees per book. Whatever I have told you about the diet plan is enough to practice it and get the benefit. But if you want to know more, you can buy the books. After listening, you may have some doubts whether you will get weakness and all. So let me show you some of my pictures. 1 year after starting the diet plan, I ran my first half marathon in my life at the age of 49 years. And I could run 21 kilometers in 2 hours 56 minutes. Then 2 hours 54, 2 hours 46, like that. I run 2 marathons, half marathons every year. I can run 21 kilometers in less than 2 hours 45 minutes. Then I donate blood, at least on my birthday. And to donate blood, your HB should be more than 12.5 gram percent. My HB is 14.5, 15. I donated more than 50 times till this date. So this was my first birthday after the diet plan. This is 15, 16, 17, 18. What I am trying to emphasize is I can run 21 kilometers. I can donate blood because I eat only twice. So will you have any problem? Are you required to run 21 kilometers from tomorrow? No. Do you have to donate blood? No. Can you follow this diet plan? Will you follow this diet plan? Very good. So Pune University will be more healthy. Then the campaign started in 2013. There are so many coordinators with me, they follow this diet plan and all. We use social media for this campaign. Now look at the crowd. People sitting on the stage. Now why people come? Not that Dr. Dixit is popular, but they come to take hope. They got a doctor who says your health is in your hands. They got a doctor who says you can revert your diabetes. You don't require any doctor or anybody to do that. That's the reason why people come for the lectures. We have taken more than 300 lectures. Our team has taken more than 300 lectures. My lectures on YouTube, they are available in English, Marathi, Hindi, three languages, and they are watched by more than 40 lakh people as of now. This is our trust that we established, and which is in Pune only. Association for Diabetes and Obesity Reversal Trust. This is the logo of the trust. This is our website. You can get information on this website about our events and everything. adortrust.org. We are launching our app, which will be available on 15th of December on the Play Store. You can download it. Our aim is that this simple method, lifestyle modification, should be included in the international guidelines for treatment of diabetes. So whenever you are diagnosed to have diabetes, your diabetologist should tell you that we'll give you medicine later. First 3 months, follow this. If you don't get benefit, then we'll give you medicine. That is our first aim. And second aim, the world should be free from these two ailments. Our future plans, we want to go to schools. We started this program in Nasik. We want to reach 2 lakh children from Jilla Parishad schools. And what is the advice? Our advice is eat 4 times, not 2 times, 4 times. Avoid cold drinks. Don't eat foods which are having more of salt and oil. And lastly, at least 1 hour you play on the ground. No mobile football. Your kids are playing now football on mobile. They don't go on ground. This is a simple message. So that is our one program. Another is diabetes reversal centers. We started one in Nagpur, 14th September. Second at Sholapur, 15th October. Third, 24th November, we started in Nasik. And next month we are starting in Pune. And here, the idea of the center is that the doctors and patients together will have the same motto of reducing medicines, stopping medicines. That would be their idea. And in our Nagpur DRC, we have found that out of the 69 people who registered, in 23 of them, the medicines have reduced to half. So next year probably the medicines would be stopped. Then we are conducting a multicentric research also. We will be selecting 5 diabetes reversal centers and where this study will be done. What do I expect from you? Don't believe me, believe yourself. If you find that I am telling science, there is a logic, do it for yourself. 3 months, not more than that. If you get benefit, join the campaign. You can join our research. You can give financial support. You can organize lectures. And this is very important. If you want to join us, these are the numbers. You can take a photograph of this slide. If you want to join the campaign, what you are supposed to do? Get your 2 tests done, HbA1c fasting insulin. Take the photograph and share on any one number which is given. What will happen now? They will give you a diet plan message depending on your condition, whether you are weight loss, pre-diabetes or diabetes. You will get a message in Marathi, Hindi or English as per your choice. So that diet plan message is a ready reckoner. Whatever given in the diet plan message, you have to follow word by word. Don't go beyond that. If we have mentioned black tea, don't ask about black coffee. If you mention about buttermilk, don't ask about black pepper to be added or not. Whatever we have said, you follow it. You will get a success story every morning. People losing weight, people becoming non-diabetic and all that. That will motivate you, keep you motivated. And this WhatsApp group, we have got around 215 WhatsApp groups. There are some 45,000 people associated with us from 37 countries of the world. So you too can join and become a part of this larger family. There won't be any annoyance caused by the WhatsApp group. We don't allow any good morning, good night, RIP, anniversary messages here. Once warning is given, second time you are removed from the group. So there won't be any problem. So you are all welcome to join these groups. So again, I will thank Dr. Tillu for giving me this opportunity to come over here and share my ideas about weight loss and diabetes prevention. After this lecture, if you have got any questions, you can ask me. If you want to listen lecture in Marathi, you can come to Balgandhar. That also is there. With this, there are some pictures of our diabetes reversal center. I will thank you one and all for patient listening. Thank you very much.